Amrutkar, and Pratik Amrutkar have got all IIM calls being a non-engineer. So sir, first of all, let's start from what is your background, where you done your graduation from, and did you felt it while preparing that I'm not an engineer, so there will be problem, what's your background?
So I'm a commerce graduate, and then I did my chartered accountancy.
Which college from?
Arepoda College of Commerce. So it's based in Mumbai. And I also did my chartered accountancy from Mumbai. So being a non-engineer, the first biggest hindrance that we always have, it's mathematics, because the kind of mathematics that's expected in CAT exam, it's accuracy and speed, and we are not so much well versed with that kind of mathematics. So the biggest hindrance was mathematics.
Yes. And you got all IIM calls.
Yes.
So then you finally converted IIMB. So what was the feeling? Was it like a fulfilling ke mera wo dream such ho gaya? Because you tried for CAT twice.
Yes.
So first attempt you got any calls?
Or? Yeah. So in first attempt I got calls from IIM Ahmedabad, Kozhikode, Lucknow and Indore.
Okay.
And I converted IIM Kozhikode and Indore.
But
I didn't join because I always wanted to get into the top 3 IIMs. So that's why I thought, and it was not like I had some financial pressure. So I thought maybe it would be better if I try another year, and then maybe I can go into some of the good IIMs. Yeah. So that's why I gave it a shot, and finally I converted IIM Bangalore and Calcutta.
So you took a gap of 1 year or?
No, I didn't take a gap because firstly I'd already taken a gap for the first attempt, and then I thought, oh, I've already studied it for first time, then I don't think so that would be it would require much of a time effort, but rather I would have to polish my mistakes and what I did wrong. So I had to improvise on that. So that, rather than that, I kept working, because it's also important to keep working because it's very difficult to justify in the interviews. Yes, I was working with Incred Capital in Mumbai itself.
And CFA, that was after CFA, before CFA?
No, along with that I was doing CFA. Yes, so I have already cleared CFA level 2.
Level 2 you did here or before coming here?
Before coming here.
Okay.
So I was preparing for CFA level 3 while I came here.
Okay. Now you are still planning to give level 3 with the hectic schedule?
I already written CFA level 3 in June.
Oh, you already given?
Yeah.
That
so after coming, to, after, coming here. After coming here, I studied for 1 week.
Okay. Oh. There's a direct correlation between the mocks and your percentile.
Correct. Yes.
So what advice would you like to give to students?
Sure.
Those are starting in preparations.
So what would
be the right advice?
So firstly, I would request every student here to invest some time in preparing the subject course, because of course it's important to know what the subject is about and then go with the mocks. But once you are done with the subjects, you should start writing exams, because writing exams will help you know which knowledge, which subject course you're lacking in, and then you can just focus on that kind of topic. So let's say in DILR you are not well versed with maybe the cubes, so you can just focus on cubes and improvise on that and save time and again write another mock, because CAT is also about speed as well as accuracy, so you should also focus on speed and write more and more mocks.
Brilliant. And what is the value of CFA? Did you feel there's a value of CFA for in your entrance exam? Did it help you convert IIM Bangalore?
In CFA exam, not particularly with respect to CAT, but when you appear for the interviews, when the college gets a kind of diverse people, so a person with non-commerce, non-engineer background, a person who has CFA, it shows that he has some inclination towards finance. Then the interview tends to go in that direction. Mm. So because it's a subject specialization, you would be having better domain knowledge in the field of finance. So of course, it always works good. Yeah. And so, being a US course and international recognized course, of course it could add a great value to your CV.
So he is a live example of multitasking. Aapne sab kuch kiya dikhaya hai to.
Yeah, you can say that.
Organizer of the event as well, and then academic record, extracurriculars. So so how you find time for all these activities?
To find time is not much a big deal, because firstly you should have inclination to do things. So to give about my background, being a CA, you don't get much time to invest in the college activities in your undergrad, because we are bound to go for articleship for 3 years. So therefore, when you come to IIMBU, there are so much host of opportunities available for you. So you tend to give time to each and everything. So like studies, sports, then various activities, the club activities, the events. So it's kind of a fun month that I've had over here till now.
Okay, last question. So how that your daily schedule should look like when you're preparing for the exams?
So for a person like me who's working us around like 9:30 to 7-8. So what I used to do is I used to invest some time in the morning and some time in the night. So I used to wake up at around 6, study for 1 or 2 hours, try to give my maximum in this morning because it's the best time to study, then go to work, then come back from work, then relax for some maybe half an hour, 1 hour, and then again start working and give to us. So because in CAT it's also very important to be in touch with the topics, right? Because there are so many topics, there are so many small intricacies, it's very important to stay in touch with the subject. So that's how I kept my busy schedule. And on the weekends when there used to be a holiday, so I used to divide my time in three different subjects, because let's say you're working on one subject the whole day, it tends to hamper your efficiency. So therefore I used to divide my day in three different subjects, so it used to help me improve my efficiency as well as help me being productive.
Great. And that was when you were working, and when you took a gap.
In the first year, because there was not much work, so I used to study like maybe 10 hours a day minimum, and being a chartered accountant, you're used to working for long hours.
Used to that.
Yeah, I used to study for long hours, so therefore it was kind of in a habit to study for 10 hours, 12 hours. So that was on Saturday, right? And I used to analyze that mocks for whole week, for whole Sunday, right? So that helped me to study my, to help prepare my study plan for the next week, for the next whole week, from Monday to Friday. Then again give a next mock on Saturday, then again analyze on Sunday, the whole Sunday, because there are around almost 100 questions, but it's very important, 100 marks, right? So it's very important to give as much time as you can on analyzing the test, because that helps you to find out which area you want to focus on.
Okay, so how we used to make a strategy? For example, I gave mock today,
right?
It is an LC,
right?
If my writing is wrong,
right?
So based on that, you used to decide the next week.
Yeah, so let's say I've given a mock today. So the next day, I used to go through each and every question, and I used to try to see whether I have given my best, and this is the best attempt I can give, and this is the smallest amount of effort that I can give. So let's say there's a question in which I am giving maybe 1 minute. So can I make it lesser? Can I solve that question in maybe 50 seconds, 40 seconds? Because this is what CATs involve, right? You need to be very efficient in solving the sum. So this is how I used to plan. And let's say I'm consuming a lot of time in some one topic, then I should study that topic in the next weekday, morning and nights, and also try to find various solutions where I can reduce the time I'm involving in each sum.
Brilliant. So thank you very much for coming, and all the best for your summer internship. Will be coming soon.
Yeah, it's coming soon. It's in October.
October.
Yeah.
So you have 1 month to sink in.
Yeah, correct.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you.